time for some comedy. Please put your hands together for Rod Woodward.
Wow, thank you very much. How are you doing? It's great to be here. We're living the dream tonight. And I got to be honest with you, I'm not used to this excitement. I don't know about you. I live in a little village in South Wales, half Welsh, half Italian. Very close-knit, very cozy, very intimate little village. I didn't realize how intimate it was, but I took a girl out from the village, you know. She took me home to meet her parents, and they were mine. I couldn't believe it. Mum and Dad, what a pleasant surprise this is. But that's how it is in the village, you know. We had a look-alike competition, and everybody won. It was crazy. But having said that, you know, life is simple there. Life's very simple. We had thick and chunky stew for dinner last night. And that's not a meal, by the way. That's my wife's brother, Stuart. he's a rugby player with a very low IQ. But he came in, thick and chunky stew, one of these bodybuilder types, you know. He came up to me and went, "Hey, I can bench press 200 kilos. What can you do?" I said, "Well, I don't like to boast, but I can read." And he knocked me out, but you got to make your point. Awkward conversations, you know, you get them all the time. I don't know what it is in this country with the nuisance callers now. There's always someone calling you, trying to sell you something. I'm too polite. I can't get rid of them, but I figured out what you got to do. You just got to act a bit unhinged, a little bit crazy. Because I swear to God, it clears the line in no time. I had a double glazing salesman come on. He wouldn't take no for an answer. I thought, a bit crazy. He said, "We'll beat any quote." I said, "Really? I just had a quote for the entire house to be double glazed." He said, "How much?" I said, £12.50. He said, "Who gave you that price?" I said, "My nana." That's when I knew I had him. He said, "Your nana could double glaze the entire house for £12.50. I said, "I doubt it." He said, "Well, you just said she could." I said, "You never said she had to do the job. You just said she had to give me a quote." He lost it big time. He said, "Let her do it." I said, "No chance. You want to see the cock-up she made of our extension? Unbelievable." She didn't even apply for planning permission. What's going on? My people are funny, aren't they? British people are funny. They don't even know half the time. The things I hear, I love it. You want a cup of tea? Only if you're making one. How else are you going to have when you map it? Sometimes you can't even get a straight answer. Cup of tea? Ooh. I wouldn't say no. Well, say yes then, innit? It's not rocket science. My wife's doing it. I come out the house the other day. I said, "Did you put the alarm on?" She said, "Ooh, I want to say yes." I said, "Well, knock yourself out. Because then I won't have to go back and check, you know." It's like the time in London. Nobody asks you for the time anymore. They've obviously had a bad experience with the time at some point in history. It's got to be the right time. Someone come up to me in Piccadilly Circus. "Have you got the right time?" I went, "No, not the right time, no." I said, "I got a mental time on me, if that's any good to you. Just let me get the balls in Mickey's ears here." Unbelievable. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Being here with you tonight has been the privilege of a lifetime. Thank you.
Come to our final act of the night.